Hey everyone, we're Justin, April, and Liam from April Justin TV.
Hi, April, Justin, and Liam.
Well, hello, Eleanor. Thanks for asking us to read a story for the Story Circle at Cool School.
Oh, no problem. Hey, can we read one of my very favorite stories of all time? The Little Red Hen?
Yes, we can. Are you ready?
Are you ready? Okay, the kids are ready.
Okay, the Little Red Hen, here we go. Once upon a time, there was a little red hen who lived on a farm and who loved to bake. And all the other farm animals loved eating her cookies, cakes, brownies, blondies, cupcakes, halo halo, banana bread, muffins, and I'm getting hungry just thinking about it. The Little Red Hen loved to bake, and she especially loved baking pies. Look, the Little Red Hen even has a blueberry pie cooling on her windowsill right now. Early one spring day, the Little Red Hen bought some seeds to plant her garden. The garden is where all the yummy ingredients for her pies came from. It was a lot of work, and since all the other barnyard animals enjoyed her sweet treats so much, she thought, "Of course they will help me."
"Who will help me plant my garden?"
"Not I," said the cat.
"Not I,"
said the pig.
"Not I,"
said the donkey. They said they were busy, but the cat was just lounging in the sun, flipping through magazines. The pig was relaxing in a hammock, texting his friends, and the donkey was meditating, which looked a lot like staring into space.
"Well, they must be busy, or else they would definitely help me."
But they sure didn't look very busy, did they? Her little baby chicks did what they could, using their tiny beaks to help plant seeds in the dirt. Aren't they cute? That summer, the Little Red Hen's garden grew in beautifully. Look, there are sweet blueberries and big juicy strawberries. The Little Red Hen knew it was going to be a lot of work picking all those berries, and so once again she asked her friends,
"Who will help me?"
"Not I," said the cat.
"Not I,"
said the pig.
"Not I,"
said the donkey. But the cat was playing a video game, the pig was trying on new shoes he had just bought, and the donkey was just chewing bubblegum and blowing huge bubbles. But look, her little chicks are getting bigger. The chicks help their mother, all working together to pick the berries and of course eat a few. Once the little red hen gathered all the sweet berries from her garden, she began to make the most scrumptious treats. The yummy smells filled the air, drifting past the kitchen, out the window, past the cat who was so busy reading a comic book in the barn, past the pig who was quite busy splashing around in the mud, and all the way past the donkey who was very busy bumping his head against the fence for no reason at all.
Ow!
Donkeys can be like that. The animals all stopped and sniffed and shouted,
Little Red Hen is making a pie!
They all ran as fast as they could to Little Red Hen's kitchen.
"I just made some wonderfully scrumptitiously deliciously perfect pies. These might be the best pies I've ever baked. Now I wonder who will help me eat these."
"I will,"
said the cat.
"I will,"
said the pig.
"I will,"
said the donkey. Suddenly, all the barnyard animals wanted to help the little red hen.
"But you're all way too busy,"
she said.
"My little chicks will help me."
The cat, the pig, and the donkey cried out,
But we want to help.
"Aren't you too busy?"
"Not I,"
said the cat.
"Not I,"
said the pig.
"Not I,"
said the donkey.
"Please, we just want to help."
"Well, I guess you could help me clean all these dishes."
The little red hen really makes a mess when she bakes. But the cat, the pig, and the donkey helped her tidy up the kitchen without a single complaint. They washed and dried all of the little red hen's dishes and put them away, except the donkey. He wasn't so good at putting them away.
Oops.
The little red hen was so grateful she gave them each a giant slice of pie with a heaping scoop of vanilla ice cream. Yum. The animals promised they would help in the garden from now on. After all, they said, if they all pitched in, there would be even more berries to bake into delicious pies. The little red hen agreed, and they all ate happily ever after. The end.
Yay! I love that story!
Me too, but it made me hungry.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Miss April, can we bake a pie now?
Good idea. Bye, guys!
Hey guys, this is Brittany and Austin from the Knive Knolls.
We're gonna be reading The Legend of Sleepy Hollow.
Ichabod had carved some really awesome jack-o'-lanterns, but he picked out the very scariest pumpkin, as it was sure to win first prize. He was just so darn excited. He was rushing out the door when he slipped on some pumpkin guts and slipped! Woo! Whoosh! When he landed, his prize-winning jack-o'-lantern was stuck on his head!
Oh no!